Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University, and as extension of our name reaction series, today I'm going to discuss about Dieckmann condensation. Today I'm going to discuss about Dieckmann condensation, where reaction, reagent, mechanism and some of the synthetic application today I'm going to discuss here. You see, Dieckmann condensation means the condensation in between a two ester where containing alpha hydrogen in presence of base to get a beta keto ester. You can see here this two ester having a alpha hydrogen to get it enolized and to attack on another ester. So we'll be getting here a cyclic ester that known as a beta keto ester. So we'll see what kind of steps will be going through this reaction. So you see here this beta keto ester having a both ester having a enolizable proton. If we add base in it, so in presence of base is like sodium methoxide and sodium amide, sodium hydride, potassium hydride. If you add it here, this ester will be getting enolate, forming enolate, and that enolate can attack on this ester to cyclize it. So this kind of transition state will form in this, where a anion will be generated, and on workup or on protonation of this anion, we will be having a beta keto ester in this reaction. Okay, this is one of the another reaction or another extension for this reaction, Thorpe-Ziegler cyclization in presence of base to get a immunonitrile. This is one of the extension of Dieckmann condensation. Then we'll going to see now what is the mechanism for this reaction. If you add base in it, one of the proton of ester will be getting deprotonated and enolate will generate. You can see in next step here, this enolate is formed at this position by abstracting one of the proton from that carbon, and this enolate will attack on another ester to form a cycle, five-membered cyclic ring. Remember friends, this reaction can form five-membered cyclic ring, six-membered cyclic ring, seven-membered, eight-membered cyclic ring, but as per the rings, carbon increasing, yield of product will be decreased. So this is a better to make a five-membered ring via this reaction, will be giving more yield. So you can see here, by coming this anion reverse, will be releasing one of the O minus ion, and that O minus ion will take this proton, which is so acidic, having a 2 keto at the alpha position. So it will be getting enolate formation, and that on workup, that enolate will be quenched with proton, and will be getting here cyclical beta keto ester. And this reaction is known as Dieckmann condensation. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, comment, share and subscribe our channel, not to miss next video about name reaction. Thank you.